So we'll start sitting on our mats in Vajrasana, hips on your heels. You can sit cross-legged to begin with, whatever, however you're comfortable. Great to see everyone tonight. Oops. All the people went into the gong bowl. Here, give you the bed vibration. It's the list of everyone in here. All right. So let's sit down. Everyone start thinking about your intention, your sankalpa. How do I want my life and love to live through me? So bring your hands together very slowly in until Anjali Mudra. Feel your energy body as your hands come together at your heart chakra and set your intention or your sankalpa for the class. It can be one word, a series of words, patience, honesty, or, you know, just say it to yourself three times, wherever you're at, something you want to work on. Deep inhales, long, slow exhales. And then we'll separate our knees and come down between our knees. Extend your hands, keep your toes together, right into a nice child's pose. Inhale, 4 seconds. Exhale, 4 seconds. You want to engage your breath throughout the entire series. So keep it slow and even. We're going to come up to tabletop. We'll do a few warm-up exercises to start. So you're at tabletop, your wrists are underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips. Raise your right arm up high, open up your chest, and then thread the needle. Drop your right shoulders, your right ear underneath. You can raise your arm and hands and ceiling. Bring your scapula together. This is wringing out your shoulders, opening up your shoulders. You can bring your arm behind you or out front towards the mirror. Just working things out. Beautiful. And then come right back up. We're going to just twist on our knee, right arm up to the sky. Press it to the knife edge of your right foot. And then come up for a nice little reverse kneeling side angle stretch. And then come back down and stretch your fingertips towards the mirror. Feel that entire stretch all along your right side. Really fantastic stretch. Wake things up. And then come back to tabletop. And we'll raise our left arm up high, open up the chest, and then thread the needle. Left arm underneath your right. Drop your left shoulder, your left ear to the floor. Raise your right arm up high. Bring your scapula together. Arm can be behind your back. It can go forward towards the mirror. Level up, level down, however it works for you and feels good for your body. Then come back to center. Your hand goes underneath your heart. You pivot on your right knee. Come up for a kneeling side angle stretch. Press into the knife edge of your left foot and then come up for reverse. Look up, dial your little pinky finger down. Come back down, stretch your fingertips towards the mirror. Feel that stretch all along the left side. Really beautiful. Very good. And then come back to center. And we'll do a little cat-cow. So inhale, look up for cow pose. Drop your belly. Exhale, pull your belly in. Drop your head for cat. Waking up the spine. Inhale, cow. Look up. Exhale, cat, pull your belly in, Uddiyana Bandha. Inhale, cow. And exhale, cat, pull that belly in. Then you're gonna curl your toes up underneath and push back into a downward facing dog. Bend your knees, move your hips right and left, side to side. And you wanna make sure your index fingers point towards the front mirror. Spread your fingers wide, get the weight into the front part of your hands between your thumbs and your index finger. Very good. So then set your gaze back towards the back of your mat and then push against your fingers. Really lift your hips, scoop your tailbone. And then we're going to come forward to a high plank. To modify, come down to your knees. Then push back into downward facing dog. Just warming things up. Come inhale, high plank. Exhale, downward dog. One more time. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, teeny little steps to the top of the mat. Now, grab your elbow. Separate your feet so they're shoulder width apart. Grab your elbows and hang in a nice rag doll posture. So hang your head. Your head weighs 9 pounds. Relate in gravity. Do some of the work here. You can feel your lower back and an opening in your hamstrings. So we're stretching out the back of your legs. And then fingers to the floor. Switch out your hands. And then if you need to, like, just rock and roll a little bit, you can. Whatever feels good. We're just warming up here. Release your hands, toe heel back together. You want your toes together and your heels slightly apart. We're gonna roll up vertebra by vertebra and stand up, palms towards the mirror. This is Samasthiti. Shrug your shoulders up to your ears and bring your scapula together down your back. Two more times, up and down. One more time, up and down. All right, raise your arms up over the ceiling. This is Tadasana. Dial your little pinky finger in. If you're new to this series, this is where we always come back to. Make your hands like cactus. Cactus backward bend. So squeeze your butt, lift your chest, look back across the ceiling, use your eyes to move your head. Bring your palms together, fold forward, fingertips next to your little toes. Inhale, lengthen and look up. Exhale, plant your hands, walk or float back to a high plank. Then lower down, chaturanga, push back up into an upward facing dog. Roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk or float to the top of the mat. Roll on up, stretch up to root down. Cactus backward bend. Now we're going to go a little faster now. Hands in prayer position. Roll forward. Inhale, lengthen and look up. Exhale, plant your hands. Walk or float. High to low plank. Straighten your arms. Lift your chest. Uddha Mukha Svanasana. Upward facing dog. Roll over onto your toes. Lift your hips up. Downward facing dog. So lift your hips. Scoop your tailbone. Feel that stretch. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk or float to the top of the mat. Roll on up, stretch up to root down. Little cactus backward bend, lift that chest, keep the hips square. Palms together, roll forward. Inhale, lengthen and look up. Exhale, plant your hands. Walk or float, high to low plank. Lower down, chaturanga, straighten your arms, lift your chest, upward facing dog. Roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward, exhale, walk or float. Top of the mat, roll on up, stretch up to root down. Cactus backward bend, hands in prayer position, roll forward. Inhale, lengthen and look up. Exhale, plant your hands, walk or float. High to low plank. Straighten your arms, lift your chest, upward facing dog. Roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, downward facing dog. So we're gonna do a warrior run. One, right leg backing up behind you, swing it through. Land in between your hands and come up for a warrior one. So your foot is at 45 degrees, your knee is over your ankle, straighten your arms up towards the sky. If you feel guided, bring your palms together, interlock your fingers, and look straight up. Now root down through the back knife edge of your left foot and stretch up. Inhale, exhale, sit down a little more. Inhale, exhale, hands to the mat. Push back into downward facing dog. Other side, left leg backing up behind you. Swing it through, land it between your hands. Come up for that warrior one. Stretch up to root down. Bring your palms together. Look up, stretch up. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, sit down, exhale. Hands to the mat. Push back into downward facing dog. All right. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk or float. Top of the mat. Roll on up. Stretch. stretch up to root down, cactus backward bend, hands together, prayer position, inhale, lengthen and look up, exhale, plant your hands, walk or float, high to low plank, straighten your arms, lift your chest, Uddiyana Mukha Svanasana, roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, Adho Mukha Svanasana. All right, second set, warrior one, right leg backing up behind you, swing it through, come up, stretch up to root down, palms together, look up, sit down a little more, bend that right knee, straighten that back leg, and hands to the mat. Push back into downward facing dog. Left leg backing up behind you, swing it through, land it between your hands, come up for that warrior one. Stretch up to root down, hands together, look up, stretch up, inhale, exhale, sit down a little more, inhale, exhale, hands to the mat, push back into downward facing dog, inhale, look forward, exhale, walk or float, roll on up, stretch up to root down, cactus backward bend, hands in prayer position, roll forward, inhale, lengthen and look up, exhale, plant your hands, walk or float, high to low plank, straighten your arms, lift your chest, upward facing dog. Roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward, exhale, walk or float. Top of the mat. Now with your toes together, heels slightly apart, come up and sit down into a chair pose. Very good, stretch up to root down. Weight back into your heels, pull up through the arches of your feet. Hands in prayer position at your heart chakra. Rotate your shoulders and chest to the right side of the room. You can hook your left elbow on top of your right knee. You can place your left fist into your right hand and twist, open it up. Then bring your hands to prayer position. Come back up for a chair, sit down, root down, stretch up, weight back into your heels. Hands in prayer position, rotate to the left, mirror side of the room, hook your right elbow on your left knee, and push your right fist into your left hand, and rotate, stack those shoulders. Very good, everyone. Inhale, slowly come up, stretch up to root down, Tadasana. Backward bend, hands in prayer position, roll forward. Inhale, lengthen and look up. Exhale, plant your hands, walk or float. High to low plank, lower down, straighten your arms, lift your chest, upward facing dog. Roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, downward facing dog. All right, so inhale, look forward, exhale, come jump or float to the top of the mat and then come up, chair pose. Beautiful, hands in prayer position, rotate your shoulders and chest to the left side of the room. This time you want to open up your arms, you can. Really twist it, pull your belly in, twist, and bring your hands back to prayer position. Sit down a little more and twist to the left. Open up your arms, look up. I want to see if your right eye can see your left thumb. And then come up to prayer position, stand up to root down, and then fold forward, separate your feet so they're shoulder width apart. Place your hands underneath your feet, toes to rest, wrist creases for a gorilla pose. Roll your weight into your toes, lift your hips up, straighten out the back of your knees, elbows out to the side, drop your head down. Beautiful. All right, release your hands, toe heel together. Inhale, lengthen and look up. Exhale, plant your hands, walk or float. High to low plank. Lower down, chaturanga, straighten your arms, lift your chest upward. Roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, downward facing dog. So let's do a triangle series. Right leg backing up behind you, swing it through, land it between your hands. Pivot your left heel down, windmill your arms up into triangle. Right knee over your right ankle, press into the knife edge of your left foot, your right big toe mount. And it's a tug of war between your fingertips. So relax your shoulders down. Inhale, tilt to a bent knee triangle. Exhale, reverse. Inhale. And exhale. One more. Inhale. And exhale. Very good. Come back to center. Sit down a little more. Get that thigh parallel to the floor. Inhale, tilt to triangle. Stretch up to stretch down. left arm down and around, bicep to ear, side angle stretch, feel the stretch from the knife edge of your left foot all the way up to your fingertips. Then you can bring your palm behind you, grab your shirt, your shorts, open up your chest, half bind. If available, full bind. Now if you're in full bind, you can use a prop, heel toe to birds of paradise. Stand up on that left foot, lift your right knee to the right corner of the ceiling. Look over your left shoulder. If you can straighten your leg, you're doing birds of paradise. Beautiful Mary. Nicely sub-ground. Good job, everyone. Hands to the mat. Push back into downward facing dog. So it doesn't matter where you're at in that. You're just trying it out. Other side. Left leg backing up behind you. Swing it through. Land it between your hands. Pivot your right heel down. Windmill your arms up. Virabhadrasana 2. Inhale. Tilt to triangle. Stretch up. Stretch down. Exhale. Reverse. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Come back to center. Tug of war with your fingertips. Sit down a little more. Inhale. Tilt to triangle. Stretch up. Stretch down. Bring your right arm down and around. Bicep to ear. Guitar hero. Feel that stretch all along the right side. Right from your fingertips all the way down to your toes. Beautiful. Bring your arm behind you for a half bind. If and open up your chest, you can stay in half bind. If you have the full bind, if in full bind, heel toe, look forward in the mirror. Birds of paradise, lift your left knee to the left corner of the ceiling. Look over your right shoulder. If you can straighten that left leg, you're doing birds of paradise. If it's just bent, that's okay as well. Hands to the mat, push back into downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward, exhale, walk or float. Top of the mat, roll on up, stretch up, root down, cactus backward bend, hands in prayer position, roll forward, inhale, lengthen and look up, exhale, plant your hands, walk or float, high to low plank, lift your chest, Buddha Mukha Svanasana, roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, Adho Mukha Svanasana. All right, so we're going to do a straight leg triangle, Ekapada Adho Mukha Svanasana, one-legged downward facing dog. So right leg backing up behind you, flex your foot, point your toe, lift your leg even higher. Externally rotating your hip to the right side of the room. Open your hips, stack your hips. Bring your hips back to center, flex your foot, bring your foot 3.5 feet up from your back foot, straighten both legs, hands on your hips, come up. Need to modify, put a block next to your foot, right hand on hip, left arm up to the sky. Slowly bend forward, lengthen through the crown of your head. Place your hands, shin block, foot or floor. Rotate your shoulders and chest to the right side of the room. Stack those shoulders. Once they're stacked, hips remain square. Raise your arm and hand to the ceiling. Parivitra Trikonasana, twist it out. Hands to the mat. Push back into downward facing dog. Other side, left leg backing up behind you. Flex your foot, point your toe, lift your leg even higher. Externally rotating your hip to the mirror side of the room. Open the hips, stack the hips. Bring the hips back to center. Flex your foot, bring your foot 3.5 feet up from your back foot. Straighten both legs, hands on your hips. Come up, Parivitra Trikonasana. Right arm up to the sky. Left arm stays on hip, stretch it up. Inhale, slowly bend forward. Keep that spine parallel to the floor. Lengthen through the crown of your head. Place your hand, shin block, foot or floor. Rotate your shoulders and chest to the left side of the room. Once they're stacked, raise your arm and hand to the ceiling. Look up, close your left eye, open your right eye, see if you can see your thumb. Open up that chest. Hands to the mat. Push back into downward facing dog. All right, inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk or float, top of the mat. Roll on up, stretch up, root down. Cactus backward bend, lift that chest. Palms together, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen and look up. Exhale, plant your hands. Walk or float, high to low plank. Straighten your arms, lift your chest. Upward facing dog. Roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up. Downward facing dog. All right, so right leg backing up behind you. Straight leg triangle. Bring it through. Pivot your left heel down. Windmill your arms up. So your right leg is straight. And fingertips have that tug of war. Then with your right fingertips, forward towards the mirror and down. So tilt to that straight leg triangle. Exhale, reverse. And inhale, straight leg triangle. Exhale, reverse. Inhale. And exhale. Back to center. Pivot that right heel in. We're going to do a straddle pose. Inhale, stretch up. Exhale, slowly bend forward. Stretch from the lower spine. Place your hands on the floor in front of you. Extended downward dog. You can walk them in, or you can grab your heels from the outside. All five fingers underneath each heel. Roll your weight into your toes. Look at the floor between your feet. Chin away from your chest. Thighs tight, knees locked, belly in, spine straight. Exhale, pull your heels. Touch your forehead to the floor between your feet. Feel the stretching along your entire backside. Hips, thighs, hamstrings, lower back, all the way down to your neck. Keep your thighs tight, knees locked. Roll your weight into your toes. Look at the floor between your feet. Chin away from your chest. Pull your belly in. Exhale. Touch your forehead to the floor. Belly in. Arms out sideways. Slowly come up. Flat back. Straight spine. Pivot your right heel towards the mirror. Cartwheel your hands down. Push back into downward facing dog. Other side. Left leg backing up behind you. Swing it through. Land it between your hands. Pivot your right heel down, straight leg triangle. Come up to the straight leg triangle. So that left knee is straight. Left fingertips forward and down. Inhale. And exhale, reverse. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Come back to center, pivot your left heel in, interlock your fingers behind your back. Dandayamana Vipakti Pada Pachi Mo Panasana, slowly bend forward, bring your scapula together, and come forward, lift your fist up towards the ceiling, chest down towards the floor. If this hurts your shoulders, you can place your hands on the floor in front of you. So level up, level down, whatever you need to do. All right, very good, and wring out those shoulders, beautiful. Then bring your hands to the mat. We're gonna sit down in a yogi squat. Bring your palms together, elbows against your knees. This is a great hip opener. So you can stay here in the yogi squat. If you have the crow pose in your postures, you can do the crow. I will demonstrate a crow prep. So how to learn. So you stand on a block, place your hands shoulder width apart on the floor, spread your fingers wide, bend your elbows, put the top of your knees on the top part of your legs, roll forward, right foot up, right foot down, left foot up, left foot down. If you have both feet up, you're doing crow. Beautiful, everyone, good work. Come back to the malasana, sit up a little more. Very good, hands to the mat, come back up into that straight leg triangle, then cartwheel your hands down, push back into a downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward, exhale, walk or float to the top of the mat. Roll on up, come to the middle of the mat if you need to. We're gonna do Garudasana, eagle pose. So bring your right elbow under your left, cross wrap, twist, palms together. Pull your elbows down, sit down. Arch your upper body back, shift your weight to your left, lift your right leg up high, cross it up. Twist your arms and legs together like ropes, opening up 14 major joints. Then bring your fingertips towards the mirror, arms parallel to the floor. Unwrap your leg, come down till your abdomen is parallel to the floor, chest down, leg up. Now if you want to, you can release your arms and let them fly, the eagle flies. Chest down, leg up, then come on up. Other side, left elbow under the right, cross wrap, twist, palms together. Pull your elbows down, that's the beak of the eagle. Sit down, arch your upper body back, shift your weight to your right, lift your left leg up high. Twist it all up nice and tight, like ropes. Push your left elbow into your right, right elbow into your left. Bring your fingertips towards the mirror, arms parallel to the floor. Unwrap that left leg. Come down until your abdomen is parallel to the floor, chest down, leg up. So you can stay here if you want to fly. Beautiful. Fly like an eagle. And then come on up, arms up. All right, leave your left leg, arm up in the sky, right arm behind you, pick up your right foot. We're gonna do a dancer pose. Inhale, stretch up, exhale, kick that right leg directly behind you. Charge forward, come down until your abdomen is parallel to the floor. Continuously kick your leg up behind you, seat your foot like a feather in your cap, nice baby, nice Mary. Right shoulder invisible behind you, right knee invisible behind you, two shoulders in one line. Stretch those fingertips forward, fingertips up at eye level. Kick and stretch equally in opposite directions. And change, come back. Arms up, we're gonna do the other side. Pick up your left foot, keep your two knees together. Inhale, stretch up. Exhale, kick that left leg directly behind you. Shin going up the back wall. Charge forward, bring your upper body down to your abdomen as parallel to the floor. Continuously kick your leg up behind you. See your foot like a feather in your cap. Left shoulder invisible behind you. Left knee invisible behind you. Two shoulders in one line. Great front row. Stretch your fingertips forward. Nice Amanda, nice Kristen, nice Lynn. Kick and stretch equally in opposite directions. Nice Lisa Brown. Body down, leg up. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Come back. Bring your hands together at your heart chakra. You do tree pose. Shift your weight to your left foot. Pull your belly in. Lift your right leg up till you can place your foot on the inside of your calf or the inside of your thigh. So level up, level down, whatever works for you. And then you can stay here or you can grow your tree high up into the sky and then spread your branches. Very good. You can look up. And if you want to, you can stay here. You can put your left hand on your hip. Pick up your right foot for an extended tree. Very good. Beautiful trees in the forest. Steamhouse forest. And then gently, right leg down. Other side. Shift your weight to your right foot. Pull your belly in. Lift your left foot up so you're inside of your calf, inside of your thigh. Avoid your knee. Hands in prayer position at your heart chakra. Grow your tree up high into the sky. Beautiful forest. Spread your branches. Beautiful. You look up. It makes it a little harder, more of a challenge. So if you want to do an extended tree, right hand on your hip. Pick up your left foot with your left hand. Extend your left foot to the left corner of the ceiling. Once you've got that, you can raise your right arm. Those branches up high. Extended tree, very nice Christina Morass. And then gently left leg down. So inhale, stretch up, exhale, half moon backward bend, hands together, fold forward, inhale, lengthen and look up, exhale, plant your hands, walk or float, high to low plank, lower down, chaturanga, straighten your arms, lift your chest, upward facing dog, roll over onto your toes, lift your hips up, downward facing dog. So we're going to do the half pigeon. Right leg back and up behind you, and then bring your right knee to your right wrist, and then come on down, straighten that left leg behind you. You can bring your forearms to the floor. You can use a prop. You can put a block underneath your butt or your head. If you want to put your head on the floor, you can, but you can just go to the half pigeon. That's enough. This is opening up the piriformis muscle in the right side of your hip. If you have any kind of sciatic problems, this is something you need to be doing every day, even if it's just for a minute. Good work. Deep inhales, long, slow exhales. Just let it go, relax into it. And then we're gonna sit up. You're gonna tense your fingers up in front of you. Walk your fingers in towards your hips, bend your left knee. Look over your right shoulder and grab your foot for a nice proud pigeon. Beautiful, feel that opening in your left hip. Then hands to the mat. Push back into downward facing dog. Pump it out a little bit if you need to. Left leg back and up behind you. Bring it through. Left knee to your left wrist. Come on down. Pigeon on the other side. You can just come down into the half pigeon. If you have full pigeon in your postures, you can do that. You can place a block underneath your butt. No shame in it. It's different for different people every day. So if you've ever injured your piriformis, which I've done twice, it takes 3 or 4 months to heal. So you want to keep this stretched out. Inhale, exhale. Then tense your fingers up in front of you. Walk your hands in. Bend your right knee. Look over your left shoulder. Grab your foot. Everyone can see the proud pigeon in the mirror. Everyone's doing it. Everyone looks fabulous. Gino, you look great. Beautiful. And then come back. Push back into downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk or float. Top of the mat. Roll on up. Stretch up to root down. Cactus backward bend. Lift that chest up. Even deeper backward bends. Hands together. Roll forward. Inhale, lengthen and look up. Exhale, plant your hands. Walk or float. High plank. Lower down, chaturanga. Straighten your arms. Lift your chest. Upward facing dog. Roll over onto your toes. Lift your hips up. Downward facing dog. So right leg back and up behind you. Flex your foot. Point your toe. Lift your leg even higher. Externally rotating your hip to the right side of the room. Bend your right knee and look over your left shoulder. So you can stay here or you can flip the dog. One arm wheel. Hips up, chest up, feet shoulder width apart. Good try, Gino, that's great. Fingers towards the front mirror. Lift that hips up, chest up even more. Great tries, everyone. Bring your right hand down. We do the counter pose. Right hand underneath your hip. Left arm up to the sky. You can kick your right leg out. If you grab your right foot and extend it, that is compass pose. But you can just keep your right knee on the floor. Whatever works for you. Come back to a one-legged downward facing dog. So your right leg is up in the air. Right knee to your right elbow. Come back. Right knee to your left elbow. Come back. Right knee to your nose. And come back. Then come forward. One-legged plank. Modify, come down to your knee. Everybody ready? Try Anga. One-legged plank. Try Anga. One-legged upward facing dog. Push back into one-legged downward facing dog. Lower your right foot, downward facing dog. Other side. Left leg back and up behind you. Flex your foot. Point your toe. Lift your leg even higher. Externally rotating your hip to the mirror side of the room. Bend your left knee. Look over your right shoulder to see your foot. You can stay here or flip the dog. One-armed wheel. Hips up. Chest up. Fingers towards the front mirror. Breathe. Look up towards the ceiling. And then come down and around for your counter pose. Left arm underneath your heart. Right arm up to the sky. Kick that left leg out. Good job, everyone. If you grab your left foot, nice, crisp, and beautiful. That's the compass pose. Come back around for a one-legged plank. Come down to your right knee if you need to modify. I'm demonstrating that. So knee to your left elbow. Extend it back. Knee to your right elbow. Extend it back. Knee to your nose. Extend it back. Then come forward, one-legged plank. Trianga, one-legged plank. Trianga, one-legged upward facing dog. Push back into one-legged downward facing dog. Lower your left foot, downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk or float to the top of the mat. Those are your vinyasas. Everybody grab a sip of water and then turn around, lie down for a 2-minute savasana. Good work, everyone. Excellent. So sink right down into your central core, that place below your thinking mind. You want to stay there nice and still. Melt right into your mat. Dissolve yourself into your mat. Deep inhale, long, slow exhales. She worked really hard in the vinyasas, and you activated the prana shakti, the life force energy in your body. And you can feel that percolation of energy flowing throughout your body. Your circulatory system is pulling it through. So lay there nice and still. Let your circulatory system do the work as you just dissolve yourself into the mat. So much gratitude to be here on Monday nights. You know, you actually cannot do yoga. Yoga is your own natural state. When you do the postures, they align you and reveal to you your own true and perfect state of being. The postures are a method of experiencing yoga. So quiet your mind, free your body. Your mind will always believe everything you tell it. Feed it faith. Feed it truth. Feed it love. Deep inhale. Long, slow exhales. So thank you all for getting in here and creating this beautiful space, supporting each other here at Steam House, holding space for each other, working together. Mary, Bob, Lisa Brown, Robin, Kathleen, Hicks, Christina Brackett, Daniel Devlin, Whitney Forbes, Gino, Amanda, Jen, Kendra, Tammy, Tracy, Lynn, Travis, Alicia Perry, yes, I know your name now. I was calling her something else. Kristen Conley, Brianna, good work. Christina Mraz, great to have you here. Lori, Amy, Jen Keenan, Sheila Marston, and her daughter Morgan. My mother daughter, love to have them here. So lay there nice and still, dissolve right into your mat. Gong into quiet presence. Thoughts arise out of nowhere and subside into nowhere. Asana. We'll do a little wind removing tonight, balancing out your meridians. So bend your right knee, interlock your fingers just below your knee. Nice webbing to webbing grip. Exhale, pull the knee towards your shoulder. Avoid your rib cage. Compress your lower abdomen. So get both shoulders on the floor, elbows close to the body. Flex your left foot up. Get the left calf flat against the floor. Feel the energy between your left foot and your right knee. That's your body's pulley system. Now eyes down. Chin down, neck flat. Give yourself a double chin, good for your thyroid. Look down the center line of your body, then exhale, pull the knee towards your armpit. Nice big snuggy squeeze. And change, gently right leg down, opening up the pingala nadi, right side of the body. That's a meridian. Then on the left side of the body, interlock your fingers just below your left knee. Exhale, pull the knee towards your shoulder. Avoid your rib cage, compress your lower abdomen. Both shoulders on the floor, elbows close to the body. Flex that right foot up, get the right calf flat against the floor. Eyes down, chin down, neck flat. Exhale, pull that knee towards your armpit. Nice big squeeze and change. Opening up the Ida meridian on the left side of the body. Both knees up to your chest. Wrap your arms over your shins. Grab your elbows, forearms, wrists, or fingertips. Whatever you can get. Just keep a tight grip. Try to squeeze your knees together, upper and lower body sealed together. Relax your feet, uncross your feet. Try to get your tailbone and hips down towards the floor, your entire back flat against the floor. So eyes down, chin down, neck flat. Look down the center line of your body. Give yourself a nice big squeeze and change. Both legs down right into your savasana, 20 seconds. And that opens up the Sushumna Nadi, the central channel. So aligning your meridians. Relax right into your mat. So we'll be doing our first sit-up. If you experience knee, neck, or back pain, you do a log roll or a modified sit-up. Everyone else, toes and heels together, feet flexed, arms up over your head, thumbs crossed, inhale. Quickly sit up, roll forward, double jerk, double exhale, forehead to knees, and turn around, come to the middle of your mat. We're going to do a little Supta Vajrasana, fixed firm pose. So sit in Vajrasana, hips on your heels. Place your hands on the mat in front of you. Separate your feet. Sit down between your feet. Hips and heels touch. Nobody go to any place of pain. If this is enough for you, just stay here. Hands on your feet. Thumbs toward you. Fingers facing down. Unless pain informs you to stop. Right elbow down. Left elbow down. Both elbows are down. Top of the head. Back of the head. Shoulders relaxed against the floor. Arms up over your head. Grab your elbows each other. Forearms flat against the floor. Eyes down, chin down, neck flat, abdomen and chest lift up. Give yourself that nice, perfect human bridge. Great medical benefits. Opens up your spleen. If this hurts your knees, Travis, you can do a bridge pose right here. That just gives you, you know, if you don't want to hurt your knees. Okay. Unless pain informs you to stop, move your knees a little closer together. Knees never come up off the floor. Hands back on your feet, elbows down. Push against the floor with your elbows. Slowly, safely come up right into your hips on your heels. Okay, so arms up over your head, palms together, thumbs crossed, Ardha Kurmasana, half tortoise pose. Inhale, stretch up. Exhale, you go down. Baby fingers lightly touch the floor, forehead to the floor if you can. If not, just get it as close as you can. Wrists, forearms, and elbows stay off the floor. Now, chin away from your chest, eyes open. Please breathe. You want to sit back towards your heels as you stretch your fingertips forward. Decompress your shoulders, lengthen your entire spine. Get some space in your vertebra, some light in your vertebra. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Inhale, slowly come up. Flat back, straight spine. Stretch up at the end. Everyone together, together. Arms float down to your side, then stand up on your knees. Knees are 6 to 8 inches apart. Keep your feet at six. Ustrasana, camel pose. Hands on your hips, thumbs outside, fingers facing down. Squeeze your elbows together. Squeeze your butt a little bit. Look back across the ceiling. Lift your chest up towards the ceiling. Use your eyes to move your head. So you can stay here, or right hand to right heel. Left hand to left heel. Thumbs outside, fingers inside. Keep a tight grip. Inhale, chest up. Exhale, push your hips, thighs, belly forward towards the mirror. Lean your upper body back. Push the tops of your feet into the floor. Inhale, chest up. Exhale, hips forward. Very slowly, right hand to right hip. Left hand to left hip. Come down. Come up with control. Sit down in Vajrasana. Take a breath if you need to. Feel a little dizzy or woozy, and you need to turn around, you can. Now, if you have trouble, like getting your feet, but you're almost there, you can come up on your toes and lift that chest up like this. So if you need to do that the second time, just keep your hands on your hips. Second set, stand up on your knees, knees 8 to 10 inches apart. Anybody who wants to do the full camel, arms up over to your head, palms together, thumbs crossed, or keep your hands on your hips. So squeeze your butt, open up your chest, look back across the ceiling, lift your chest up towards the ceiling tiles. Move your eyes to use your head. Move your head to use your eyes. Okay. Right, left hand to left heel. Come up on your toes if you need to. Right hand to right heel. Thumbs outside, fingers inside. Keep a tight grip. Inhale, chest up. Exhale, push your hips, thighs, belly forward towards the mirror. Push the tops of your feet into the floor. Look for the wall behind you. Inhale, chest up. Exhale, hips forward. Arms back, way back, more back. Go back. Inhale. Slowly come up. Left hand to left hip, right hand to right hip. Come up with control. And everyone turn around, lie down, and relax in Savasana. So good work. Two of those postures in a row, opening up the front side of your spine, releasing all kinds of nice immunity chemicals and endorphins into your body. If you have any kind of winter blues, little unhappiness, depression, anxiety, worry, this is the greatest posture for that. They say that posture is guaranteed to make you happy. So lay there nice and still. Just come to yoga. Do that posture every day. Deep inhale, long, slow exhale. Feel a little queasy or whatever. Just let it go. It dissolves in a few moments, a few breaths, mind over matter. Opening up that thoracic spine from the front. We're only as young as our spines are flexible. So we're going to do some core work now. So raise your feet up over your hips, straight up to the ceiling. Point your toes, and then flex your feet and lower one third down. Inhale, exhale. Point your toes, flex your feet, lower another third. Inhale, exhale. Point your toes, flex your feet, lower. Hover off the floor, then scissor kick your legs. Back and forth or up and down, whatever feels good to you, 10 times. And then when you're done, raise your legs right back up over your hips. When you're done with the 10 times, then point your toes, flex your feet, lower one third down. Inhale, exhale. Flex your feet, point your toes, lower one third. Inhale, exhale. Flex your feet, point your toes lower till you're just a little bit off the floor, then scissor kick. If you went up and down, go back and forth. Engage your abdominals, make it work. And then when you're done with the 10 times, raise your feet back up towards the ceiling. And then what you're going to do is separate your legs right into a V shape. Then interlock your fingers and release your index fingers. Make like pointy index fingers. And then you're going to curl up. Inhale, look up, fingers through the center of your legs. Exhale down 10 times. Inhale up. Exhale down 2. Inhale up. Exhale down. Engage those abdominals. Inhale up. Exhale down 4. Inhale up. Exhale down 5. Inhale up. Exhale down 6. Inhale up. Exhale down 7. Inhale up. Exhale down 8. Inhale up 9, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down. Now leave your right leg up in the air and bring your left foot down to the floor. All right, so you can keep your left foot on the floor or you can hover that leg. Then take your index finger, you know, your grip your fingers, release your index fingers, and then you're going to go over to the right side of your thigh. Inhale up. Exhale down 10 times. Inhale up 2, exhale down. Inhale up 3, exhale down. Inhale up 4, exhale down. Inhale up 5, exhale down. Inhale 6, exhale down. Inhale 7, exhale down. Inhale 8, exhale down. Inhale 9, exhale down. Inhale 10, exhale down. Working that transverse abdominis. Now switch it out, right foot on the floor, left leg up to the air. If you want to challenge yourself, hover that right leg. All right, other side. So inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down 2, inhale up 3, exhale down, inhale up 4, exhale down, inhale up 5, exhale down, inhale up 6, exhale down, inhale up 7, exhale down, inhale up 8, exhale down, inhale up 9, exhale down. One more, inhale, engage those abdominals, then come down right into a reclining gentle pose. So bring the soles of your feet together, heels close to your tailbone, allow your abductors to open up, your knees to drop to the floor. So you can place one hand on your heart, another on your belly, or you can keep your hands on the floor next to you, whatever feels good to you. This is a restorative pose. Lay there. here, nice and still. Gravity's doing some of the work. Your knees are opening. Great hip opener here. Really, most people have no idea how good their body is designed to feel. This posture feels good. Surrender and let go. Breath is yoga. Engage your breathing. Inhale 4 seconds. Exhale 4 seconds. Very good. And then raise your feet up over your hips. Grab the outside of your feet for a happy baby. So you want to pull your knees down towards the floor as you push your heels up towards the ceiling. And you can rock and roll back and forth, massaging your spine as well. Another restorative posture. It's a hip opener. Gravity is opening up your hips. Very good for you. Right and left. Right and left. Right and left. And so release your left foot down and hold on to your right foot. So we're going to do a one-legged happy baby. So you can extend that right leg straight out. Some people can get it on the floor, or if you just have the bent knee, you can circle it around. So we're just going to do the one-legged happy baby on that right side. So whatever feels good to you. Some people, it just extending. You can use both hands if you want to. You can pull your knee in. You can extend it out. Some people can put their leg on the floor. Not everyone. Sarah Evans can. Mary Robson can. All right. And we know Robin can. The front row hotties all can. All right.
That's funny.
Oh, you're up here with all the other ones. That's all right.
That's why I'm in the middle.
All right, so we're going to switch it up. Do the other side. So right foot down, left leg up into the air. Grab your left foot so that it's the one-legged happy baby. And you just get like a little different stretch. It's kind of cool. I like this. I did this in a yoga class this week somewhere. I really liked it, so I'm sharing it with you. And you're just sort of opening up your hip in a different way. So good. All right, so come down, place your feet underneath your knees, shoulder width apart. We'll do some bridge poses. First set, everyone does the bridge. Hands on the floor next to you. Then you're going to tuck, curl, lift your hips all the way up to the ceiling. Then bring your palms together underneath your tailbone, interlock your fingers, bring your scapula together, and lift your chest even higher for that nice high bridge pose. Nice, Morgan. That looks good. Very good. Excellent. And then release your hands. Slowly lower down, vertebra by vertebra, hips down last. So we're going to do two more. The second one, if you have the wheel. If you have the wheel in your postures, you can do the wheel or just repeat that bridge pose. So everyone's set up. So if you're doing the bridge, the wheel, your hands are underneath your shoulders. If you're doing the bridge, your hands are next to your body. Inhale, tuck, curl, lift. Hips up, chest up, come all the way up. Oh God. All right. And then bring your hands underneath your tailbone, bring your scapula together, lift it up, beautiful everyone, and then slowly lower down. If you are doing wheel, don't come down on your head, come down on your shoulders first. If you do wheel, you want to not use your head, if at all possible. All right, lay there nice and still. Now on our third set, you can do bridge or wheel, and we'll do the can-can legs. So whatever works for you. So set it up, inhale, tuck, curl, lift. Hips all the way up to the ceiling. Hips up, chest up, look at the mirror. Right knee up to your chest, right foot up to the ceiling. Right knee to your chest, right foot down. Left knee up to your chest, left foot up to the ceiling. Left knee to your chest, left foot down. Then slowly lower down, shoulders down first. Come down vertebra by vertebra, hips down last. And relax right into Savasana. Let it go. Doing those beautiful back bends, so good for you. Do a plow pose. So if you have any kind of shoulder or neck issues. You're just going to have your feet straight up in the air. Or if you're near the wall, you can just put your feet up on the wall. Everyone else, you're going to rock and roll up into a shoulder stand. So place your hands on your lower back, point your toes, bring your hips all the way up. Stack your hips over your shoulders as much as you can. Point your toes. And then when you're ready, you can bring your toes behind you into the plow pose. So you're compressing your internal organs, you're stretching your spine, you're stretching your kidneys, you're giving yourself a marvelous, fantastic facelift. And then if you can bring your knees to the floor in the dead bug pose, then great. And then when you're ready, come back up into the shoulder stand and then slowly lower down vertebra by vertebra right into your savasana. One more posture. Do a spine twist on the floor. Arms out like airplane wings. Adjust with your neighbor. Scoot your hips over to the right side of the mat. Bring your knees up to your chest and allow your knees to fall over to the left side of the room. So you can eagle wrap top leg over bottom leg. You can extend your bottom leg. You can put a block between your knees, especially if you have stiff hips or if you had any kind of hip surgery. All right. And then you can place your left hand on top of your right knee as you look over your right shoulder at your right fingertips. That's your drishti. That's your viewpoint. And then feel the stretch between your hips and your ribs and relax right into it. This is a spine twist. You can get a little spine adjustment here. Then come back to center. Scoot your hips over to the left side of the mat. Bring your knees up to your chest and allow your knees to float over to the right side of the room as you gaze over your left shoulder at your left fingertips. So you can eagle wrap, top leg over bottom. You can extend your bottom leg towards the back wall. You can put a block between your knees, whatever feels good. So level up, level down, and then just feel that stretch between your hips and your ribs. Just try to relax into it. Inhale, exhale. Center and extend your arms and legs right into a savasana. So I'm going to give you a little gong bath right now before we end. And if you need to leave, you can leave after the gong bath. Just quietly get up and very quietly get out, everyone, or just quietly leave. And then everyone else, just stay there on your mat for our 15-minute guided yoga nidra meditation. So with the gong bath, you want to follow the sound of the gong into quiet presence. Thoughts arise out of nowhere, and they subside into nowhere. So right now, you just surrender into the now. Relax your body and your brain right into your mat. Deep inhale. Long, slow exhales. Consciously, breathe continuously. Your way out of the room. We'll be starting our yoga nidra in a minute or two. Everyone else, lay there nice and still, melting into your mat. we will be merging into the whole field of our awareness. It's time for Yoga Nidra Meditation. Yoga Nidra promotes deep relaxation and rest that isn't found in your average meditation practice. Let go of the yoga class. Your eyes are closed and feel yourself melting into the floor. Take deeper, longer breaths. Longer, smoother, slower breaths. Relax your shoulders. Calm and easeful. The practice of Yoga Nidra begins now. At this time, repeat your sankalpa or intention from the yoga class, or create a new one. A short positive statement, one word, a series of words. Say your intention to yourself 3 times silently. How does life and love want to live through me? Intention you make during Yoga Nidra plants a seed in the fertile soil of your consciousness to bring about transformation and healing. Say to yourself, I am practicing Yoga Nidra. I am awake and relaxed. We count down from 12 to 1. With each successive number, we will become more and more effortless. Starting with 12, feeling very soft, letting everything settle. Moving to 11, becoming a little softer. Flowing inside to 10, 9, 8, moving slowly towards 7, effortless awareness to 6. Slightly more effortless. 4, 3, very softly. 2, gently. 1, down to 0, abiding in serene awareness. We bring our attention to a few general points in the body to abide in effortless awareness, serene consciousness. Bring your attention to the space between your brows, and with your attention to that space, place there a point of light, soft, diffused, serene. Turn your attention to the center of your throat and place a point of light there, slipping into a state of awareness between sleeping and waking. Move your attention to your heart area, softening, opening, and place a point of light there. attention to your left shoulder. Point of light, so quiet, so soft, lovingly, gently slipping into a state between sleeping and dreaming. You are melting into your total awareness equally, taking in your whole field of consciousness at once. Let go. Feel the expansion within yourself. Keep merging into this expansive awareness, consciousness. Resist labeling anything that comes up. Just merge back into everything equally. Don't try to give anything a name or identify things. Just let them melt together in your awareness, consciousness. Resonate with everything at once, breathing evenly and calmly, expanding calmly into your awareness. You aren't trying to meditate or attain any special state of consciousness like being a spiritual person. It's just your awareness resonating and expanding. Deep inhales, long, slow exhales, holding space for the whole field of your awareness. Surrender into now. Resonate in your awareness. Stay there nice and still as you breathe in, expanding consciousness, and breathe out, feeling a slight contraction of consciousness. Become even more merged in your awareness consciousness, dissolving into pure consciousness, aware of your awareness. Gently dissolving mental constructs, merging, melting them, going to that place below the thinking mind, or even just before your mind starts to think a thought, before thinking or underneath thinking, resonating in that place. Relax. Notice how good it feels. Notice your expanded, luminous inner awareness, aligned, supremely free consciousness. Now, a number of different things will be named, and you should envision them on the level of emotion, memory, and imagination as best you can. Jump from image to image as soon as you hear it. A large room. Your favorite shirt. A cloudy sky. Dragonflies on a summer day. A large cup of tea. Journaling your day. A birdhouse. Salt and pepper. Comfy slippers. Ice water. Snow-capped mountains. A white church steeple. consciousness, fish swimming together, meal prep, wooden floors, midnight meditation, comfortable pants, bells tinkling, treetops, a bird's eye view, shopping for groceries, driving slowly, voices in the next room, your face in a golden mirror, the sound of my voice, the sound of my voice. It is now time to repeat your intention or sankalpa. Recall the word or short positive statement you made earlier in the yoga class or the yoga nidra meditation. Repeat your sankalpa or intention to yourself silently 3 times. Yoga Nidra is now complete. Come back to the feeling of your breath moving in and out easily and gently. Start to bring your awareness back to your body. Your torso, your heart, your limbs, the center of your throat, the space between your eyebrows. You are relaxed, lying on the floor. Visualize the room before opening your eyes. The floor, the ceiling, the walls, the mirrors. Lie quietly until you're ready to wiggle your fingers and toes. Take your time. There is no hurry. When you are ready, gently roll over to your right side. And when you are ready, open your eyes up halfway and take in the vision of your body in a simple flash. Place your hands on the floor and bring yourself up to a sitting position. So bring our hands together at our heart chakra, remembering our sankalpa, remembering that expanded awareness within us, taking that into our evening. Deep inhale, long, slow exhale. Trust your soul with care. It is your best friend. Feed it and nurture it with love. Love you guys. Namaste. Any questions or concerns, you can see me at the front desk. Beautiful, beautiful class and yoga nidra. You're welcome to stay for the next class, 26 and 2. It's only an hour. Gino, you're going to stay, right? That was a great class.
Bye. I'm gonna stay for two classes. I gotta bring two shirts on time. Check out the board.
Bob,
check out the board.